Okay, Mr. Ajayi, take one.
In the vast majority of patients, kidney stones form due to levels of dehydration, i.e. we're not drinking enough. You often hear people say you should be drinking 2 liters of water. We actually say you should be producing 2 liters of water. There's a whole different type of kidney stones. It's not just one type. There are many types of kidney stones. Some are due to dehydration, some are genetic, some are due to infections, some are due to the fact that the patients have certain acidity in their urine that causes them to form stones. We're quite fortunate at St. John and St. Elizabeth really to have a pathway already designed for renal colic patients. The route of entry is either through our urgent care center or via GP who's referred the patient to me. We have a team of highly qualified nurses and doctors who would see the patient quite promptly. They run some blood urine tests. They make a diagnosis of the stone, i.e. perform a CT scan, which is a cross-sectional imaging to identify the stone. Occasionally it's a small stone. It's made its way down the ureter and it's under 5 millimeters. And in those cases, we often try to manage it conservatively and hope the patient passes the stone spontaneously by themselves. There's a procedure we do for patients where you have large, complex kidney stones or unusual renal anatomy called a PCNL, percutaneous nephrolithotomy, PCNL. So we do them in a supine position, i.e. the patient lies still on their back, and we turn them slightly, which allows us to be able to access the kidney. Percutaneous means keyhole, okay? You're going through the skin. And what we do using the needle on the ultrasound guidance is make a tiny needle into an area of the kidney. And that needle, we get stretch at the kidney and we put a sheath over that needle, over that balloon. And we deflate the balloon and it gives you straight access to the kidney. And once you finish what you need to do, it closes that out. So we recently acquired two state-of-the-art laser technology. There's a particular laser technology called Thulium fiber laser, called a TFL. The big advantage really is one of the achievements you want as an endourologist is to be able to dust stones into finer pieces. And if you can dust stones into finer pieces, they pass easier. So an operation which would normally take 2 hours, we're now down to an hour using this particular technology. We have another laser, Holmium laser. This particular laser allows you to do what's really called a patient-centered approach. You can really approach your stone with different options. The laser technology is not just about breaking the stone down. It gives you the opportunity to either dust the stone, fragment and remove it, or we have a feature called popcorning on there. And popcorning allows you to break the stones into tiny pieces as well. Some stones are very soft. Some stones are very hard. It's called calcium oxide monohydrate. So often until you engage the stone, you wouldn't know what you're going to do. And the advantage or the real benefit we have at St. John and St. Elizabeth Hospital is the fact that we have these laser machines and you can adjust it based on the stone. Some patients keep their stone for a week or two and then we remove them in outpatients on the local or general anesthetic, depending on the patient's preference. After they've had their stone treated, they come to the outpatients and often we have the results of the stone analysis. Once you know what the stone is made of, you can really impact on the patient dietary advice in order to stop them forming stones. We work with a nephrologist as well as a dietitian to really try and knuckle down for some of our recurrent stone formers to prevent them forming future stones. It's such a unique hospital, and I've never worked in a hospital like that. There's a lot of things to be said about St. John and St. Elizabeth. One, I'd like to start off with the staff. The staff are incredibly friendly. Anybody that walks through St. John and St. Elizabeth, one of the things we pride ourselves is that patients are always welcome. We're able to get through a high volume of patients in a day because everybody knows what they're doing. Everybody knows their role. We're like brothers and sisters.